this is our coding for digital clock using the EZ68K simulator. Okay, first, X size and Y size. Define the character size. And the set tick, define the segment thickness. Except define the distance between the origin of adjacent digits and should be greater than X size. CHRSEP define the distance between the origin of the hours, minutes and seconds and it should be greater than twice. X-POS and Y-POS define the origin for the display. Code start. Turn off the keyboard HO. Set the initial color and draw the display. This only needs to be done the once. Select next color style as there are only two entries in the color table. We can toggle between them using a simple SOR instruction. Either is the first time through of the color has just been changed, so set out the last time digits to S0A to force an update of all the clock digits this time. Main program loop start here. First loop to see if a key is waiting. If there is, get it and compare it with space. If it's space, then go and change the color index and force a world display update. Time in centiseconds since midnight is now in D1. First divide this by 100. To give the time in second, to ensure that there is no overflow of the divide instruction, the long word time is split into words and each handled separately. Now divide the second into the value for each digit. There is no need to do this a word at a time as the first divide can never cause and overflow there. They are at most only 8365 tenths of seconds in a day. The current time is now divided into digits and saved to memory. Each digit is compared to the same digit the last time here. And if they differ, that digit is updated. At the first digit, match the loop, exit as all remaining digits will be the same. Extract the next digit value from the time. This is easy on the 68K as the DVU. Instruction return both the result of a divide and the remainder. In this case, the remainder is what we are interested in and is saved to the digit, the divide. Result is just plus back. Update the digit indexed by D7. First set up the pointers and indices. Make 2 mask byte. The first in D4 has bits had for each segment that needs to be turned on, and the second in D5 has bits set for each segment that needs to be turned off. This minimize the amount of drawing that needs to be done to change from the old digit to the new. Start at segment 6 and erase, draw or skip each segment as needed. The fill color is set for this segment. Now get a point from the table that is somewhere within the segment and just root fill it with the previously set draw or erase color. Then initialize the display. For each digit in turn, a filled rectangle is drawn. Then the segment outline are drawn in the background color. Finally, the upper and lower void are erased by filling them with the background color. Get the coordinate and draw the filled rectangle. Set the fill color to the background color so that the fill will remove part of the rectangle we just drew. The commands to draw the segment outlines are held in a table and are stored as command. X coordinate, Y coordinate using just the move, line and fill graphic. Commands a wide range of shapes could be drawn. End of code, start of data. Data for segment outline, first the G segment is outline, then the line A and D. Segment are drawn and connecting lines are drawn between the corners of this. And the G segment for define the B, C, E and F segment. Finally, the two inner void are cleared with two fill commands. This table defines the top left corner of each digit. They are calculated at assembly time from the values defined in the equate before the start of the code. Only the X value is saved as the Y value is the same for all digits. Display colors table. This pair of numbers are the unlit and lit colors for the different type of display. Note that neither of them can be the same as the background color as that is used to define the segment edge to bound the flute. Okay, that's all. Okay, then I will run this program. Let's click execute. Just wait for a second. Then I run it. Oh yeah, it's running smoothly. And if I press a space bar, it can change from red color to blue color. Okay, that's all. I want to asking you all a question. Then you can answer this question by write a comment in comment section. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.